Hello, good afternoon. How are you?
Very good, Frank. Good afternoon. I am fine. What about you?
I'm good as well. And how was your day going?
It was great, actually. I have given my exam. It has started actually 11 a.m. And I just gave my exam. And after that, I'm here talking to you. So that's it.
That's
even before I just prepared for my exams 1 hour, 2 hours, then after that I took my exam at 11 a.m.
Oh, how was your exam going?
It was great because I have to give the exam through online because I don't have to go in college. So this is much beneficial, right? Because we have to just give the quiz in the form of quiz. They just provide 4 options and you have to just select. It's a kind of multiple choice question, right? What is MCQ type of questions?
Yes, yes, yes. I know about that. Is it online classes good or offline classes good for you?
For me, I would say both are fair, same to me. I don't feel any kind of problem, whether I will go offline or whether I will go online, because I'm kind of study every day, every now and then, and I used to practice my questions and practice. So I think, but I would prefer more offline classes as compared to online, because when you go offline, you have to, your doubt would be resolved immediately at that particular point of time. But yes, I think personally, me, it's fine. I can take both, offline and online.
So that's very good. That's true. That if you are going offline, then whatever problem you have, you easily ask to your teacher, your professor. So it's very good. But I think in the online, you don't have that much time, and teacher also not able to convey your problems, all kind of things, isn't it? So
yeah, this is that was the thing. And apart from that, one thing I also wanted to say is, what happens, so there are some, because I have to take the classes in only one meeting, and in one meeting there are, let's say, there are 40 or 50 students in one class. So all of them, like every student will join in class. So this is the problem. And let's say there are 10 or 20 students out of 40 students, they have a doubt. Then how can they ask in just 40 minutes? So there are limited class, na? In Zoom class or Google Meet class, you can just take only 40 minutes. So this is also a kind of problem, online.
So tell me about, as you said that your exam is going on, so you are able to cheat your teacher in online?
Yeah, obviously. Obviously, definitely we can. If let's say, because sometimes we also don't get expected questions, whatever they teach, and they just ask the questions some out of the box, even you don't know the answer. So in that case, you have to do something differently. Right. You have to just go. Sorry, could you repeat that, please?
In question paper, if you don't know any answer, then you Google it and find out the answer.
Yeah, we can. Actually, it happens sometimes, but not every case. Because let's say you can easily solve the question, you can get the marks, but ultimately it doesn't matter. If you don't have knowledge, then you can get the marks. So, in my opinion, yes, you can. Because let me tell you very frankly, even every student is getting full marks, in online classes. If they are not hardworking, and if they are hardworking, means we are just treated equally. Let's say, so that's the disadvantage actually in online classes. But once you go offline, you have to write all the exams in your paper, then your potential comes, what kind of a student you are. Yeah, so this is the thing.
It's true that marks is not matter, knowledge is very important, isn't it?
Yes, no, knowledge is definitely very important, I know that, I'm from technical background, and I know that, let's say, if you gain a 9 CGPA after completing your graduation, if you get 9.1 or 9.4 CGPA, then in that context, your interviewer also might be asked some that kind of question, that level of questions, you know, like how would you get the, that kind of CGPA? If you are a kind of person, then also know that na, ki you people like you spend 2 years in your lockdown, then what you have done. So I'm just knowing all those things. Yeah.
That's very good. So something distract whenever you are studying, how you get distracted out of your studies? You have some, or you are concentrated only on your studies?
Yeah, definitely, you know, like the biggest distraction I found was, you know, my smartphone, you know, whenever I used to study, like there are some classmates, there are some mates in my college, they used to call me like quite often, you know. Sandeep, like just tell me this topic, and not every time, but sometimes they used to call me, and in that context, I just mute my phone and I just keep away from my table, and yeah, then I study. I think that this keeps me to, you know, concentrated and focus.
So, do you have any girlfriend?
Really. Like, it's an interesting question, but I don't have any girlfriend right now, because I don't have, actually, to be honest.
So you don't have. Okay, suppose I'm giving you a hypothetical situation. Suppose you have girlfriend and you have to give gift to her. What you will give to that your girlfriend?
Yeah, it's a good one, basically. Yeah, definitely, you know, like if someone will ask, yeah, some people might be say that I can give money and I can give everything, but what I feel is, what I think is, I can gift only, you know, love and everything, so that's the only thing I used to gift her, like, because that thing I used to give.
In gift, you will give love, but I'm saying gift, what kind of gift you will give? Gift, I'm talking about gift. Gift.
Okay. Yeah, gift, I can give like everything, you know. I can give which attracts, you know, like girls most, like kind of necklace and all. Yeah.
Necklace?
Yeah, definitely. Not.
Okay. So, what is the first thing you are noticed in any girl?
Okay, so it's a tricky one, because, you know, what can I say? Okay, so it's what can I observe?
What you are noticed in any girl? Their face, or their knowledge, or their dressing style, or their way of talking, all kind of things. What do you notice?
So first thing I observe, like in girls, basically, first thing I observe is that, like, the way they, like, not going for looks and all, means, yes, I can take 20-30%, like, how they looks, but their knowledge, their understandable, like, what, how they talk and how they, you know, what kind of knowledge they have, like, that's the thing I used to.
So that's, you mean to like the first thing, that knowledge?
Yeah, faces. Knowledge means this. Yeah, like this. We have like some sort of knowledge also, and this balance, you know, just maintain the balance in everywhere. It's not like that. Even your like dressing sense is not good, and you are not looking good, and so this is also not used more thing. But yes, I can give the, like, everything will be good enough. Because if you are knowledgeable, then you can understand, and nobody is going to, you know, since knowledge is important, actually, is for everything.
Okay, that's a very good answer, that you want knowledge in girls. Yes, that's true. In this today era, if you have knowledge, then it is very good. Because if you have beautiful face, but you don't have brain, and what you will do for that, isn't it?
You know, what I observed is, to be honest, what I observed in, like, because I'm in college, you know, this is the kind of mindset in youngsters have. They just going for for girls, they have very, they just attracted towards them because their facial expressions and all, so I don't think I'm that kind of person who just going for their, looking and all those things. Yes, but it matters. But yes, as I said before, knowledge, it also matters. You can't say that this person is, even you don't meet with that person, and when you don't know even, the person, how she is and how, what kind of work she is doing, and without involving and without spending time, so you can't understand things. So in my opinion, I just understand is it good for me or not, that kind of stuff.
Okay, yeah. That's very good that you are not attracted with, it's like outer beauty. You also require inner beauty too. The knowledge.
Definitely. Yeah.
Knowledgeable. Yes. So
this is mandatory. Yes.
It is very important. Knowledge is very important. Okay. Beauty is not important in today's era. Knowledge is important.
I can't deny that. It's an important thing, without a girl's in hand, what man is supposed to do? So this is also thing important thing. But yes, if you are kind of knowledge, then you can just choose that person.
Best way to approach any girl, according to you? You like any girl, so you will text a message, or you will go face to face and say that you are looking very beautiful and I love to you and you are very knowledgeable. So you will text, or you will, if you like someone, you can interact face to face. What is your opinion about that?
Okay. So personally, what I feel is, you can actually, I know that, what kind of limitation have when you text a known person. Then you just fall just go into the cave. So I mean to say that if you know that person when you met before, then it matters. You can approach towards social media platforms and a lot of social media platforms you can text. But before,
if you like somebody, you will go on social media.
No, that was not my intention actually. I mean to say that when you know each other even before, then you can go later on. I'm not saying that you are the kind of person who is stranger to me and I just go social media and I just text it to that person. Then what happens? You won't get any result. So I think the best approach you asked to me was, I want to say, means first we know each other, even you know that person, and that person is also somewhere knows to you. So then you can text and all, whatever you can do, because ultimately,
if you want to express your love and anything, so you will text. You will not go face to face. You want to say that? You mean to say that?
No. It's not. It doesn't work actually. It doesn't work. In order to. You have to go face to face, whenever you have to do.
Saying, if you like someone, how you approach? In message or face to face?
I think the best approach would be face to face. I think not it doesn't work, actually, in my opinion. Person would be thinking differently, but face to face is more attractive, I think, in my opinion. Yes.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. Whether she like or not like you. She will, tell you in your face.
Whether you rejected or not. So.
What you like in your partner? What kind of means?
Oh my God. So this is the distraction when you ask such kind of question.
Okay, no problem. Okay. No problem.
Let me just come outside. Yeah. So just. I'll just sit here, so then we can talk.
Yes, no, it's okay. So I'm saying, in any girlfriend or any friend, what you want most? Respect, loyalty, dignity, all kind of things. What do you want more?
I think the best thing what I want is, you know, like respect is very important. You know, if you,
that's true,
like that person, then you, it is first priority, I think, in my opinion. It should be there. And if they, it is not there, then you, if you like this person and that person is, doesn't like you and she doesn't respect you, I think we need to just move on. We don't need to spend more time. Yeah. Because we know that population of India, you know, and it's like 1.3 or 1.4 billion. Yeah.
Okay, only respect apart from this? Anything else?
Yeah, as you said, like, you know, loyalty and dignity, it also matters at some extent. And the, yeah, and yes, so these are the things, I think.
Okay, so I would like to tell you what I want in my partner. First of all, I want, you know, first thing, respect.
Yeah, this is the first priority.
Yeah. Respect each and every woman, every girl. Not only me, every woman.
Yeah. Electricity is can. Electricity is actually. Yeah. Carry on.
So second thing is, according to me, is loyalty.
Yeah.
Why I'm saying loyalty? Because nowadays, if you see, one boy has 2-3 girlfriends, and one girl has 2-3 boyfriends. So first of all, loyalty is very important. And third thing is, I have written knowledge. Knowledge is also. And for me, fourth thing is, he's very caring person. So fourth thing is very important.
Yeah. So, have you ever had any relationship?
No. But I have boyfriends.
Like 2 or 3.
like my in my college days, I have boyfriend. Like we are whatever problem I have, like the study problem. So I don't know what you mean by boyfriend and what you mean by lover. I don't know. Okay. I think lover is different. Boyfriend is different, according to me. So yes, like yes. Girl is girlfriend, boy is boyfriend, according to me. Hello.
Yeah. Yes,
I can hear.
Your video is not visible. I don't know why.
Yes. You are visible. Don't worry. So tell me, according to you, what is the difference between girlfriend and lover? Both are same or different?
Can I call? Actually, I have never ever been in such kind of relationship, you know. So I think the person who can give you the best answer of this, who had is, you know, spend the time and like, but for me, I think, you know, the difference means, what can I say? Girlfriend, in my opinion, girlfriend and boyfriend relationship is quite different. And, you know, if you are a kind of lover, then that person is going to spend whole time, I think, like that person married.
I'm saying about, you think we are saying boyfriend and lover. Both are different things or both are same?
Both are same, I think.
Same?
In my opinion, yes. What do you think? I think in my opinion, both are same.
Both are not same. According to me, both are not same. You may, just like you have lots of a boyfriend, okay, I have lots of girlfriend. So just like if you talk to somebody, like if they are younger or they feel like your sister, so they are like your friends. Lover is different thing because okay I will change my topic. So okay. What annoying voice about girl?
Sorry, what did you say?
What annoying voice about girl? Like somebody, if boys, I think if girl is doing lots of makeup. Maybe boys don't like. So what kind of annoy things about you feel about girl?
Okay. So personally, I would say, you know, in my opinion, the most annoying part is, you know, because what I observed nowadays is that they just means, you know, they don't, yeah, you are right. Like they just do a lot of makeups and all. This is also thing. And the bad thing was what annoyed is, you know, they just don't be that real person, you know, they just wanted to show means, you know, they don't be real and they just show something else. So this is the annoying thing. You know.
Girls are nowadays faking themselves.
Let's say if I'm a kind of person, if I'm looking this kind of, then we have to be real, you know, we don't need to take don't show off things, you know, like if that person likes you, then definitely that person will attract it towards you. You don't need to do all those things, right? So that's what I feel.
It's very wonderful that we talk a little bit. You want to ask me something related to this?
Yeah, I think the question which I asked was, so do you prefer, it's my opinion, like I just wanted to ask, do you prefer like love marriage or like arranged marriage? What's your opinion about it?
Actually, in my opinion, I will do arranged marriage.
Actually, the thing is that
I believe in arranged marriage because maybe you know, I feel that parents have lots of idea regarding boys. Okay, so I don't have idea. Maybe I become very I get fraud kind of things. I don't know. But I think nowadays people are doing love marriages and they are very success love marriages is there. So yes, both are good. It's only depend on you. But never disappoint your parents. If you are doing love marriage, if your parents are not happy, then never go for that.
Yeah, at the end of the day, like parents are our first priority because they have given us a lot of things. So yes, we have to just keep these things in mind. Yes, absolutely, I agree. But I think, you know, if the person who go for like arranged marriage and that's why, you know, in future, a lot of conflicts also arise. You know, that person, even you don't know even that person, you know, like what kind of person you get in your future. And you have to spend whole life with that person.
Nobody's people are thinking like that. But if you see the 10 year back scenario, everyone are doing arranged marriage and they are very happy. But it depends nowadays. It depends on people to people. Because nowadays, if you see, they are doing love marriage. After doing love marriage, they get divorced. If you see the Bollywood actor like Amir Khan and Kiran.
There are so many. As you said, like Amir divorced. Khan and Saif Ali Khan. Saif Ali Khan is also there. Yes. And both person married with different religions, you know. Aware about the fact, you know, in UP especially, I think UP government has given some rule laws. I think for, let's say, if you are a kind of different religion, let's say you are a kind of Muslim person and I am kind of Hindu person. So this rule has been, I think, come up in UP itself. Like love jihad case, you must have heard, right? I think maybe 1 or 2 months before, it was quite famous in news. I think in now you cannot do such kind of things. Let's say if your religion is different and my religion is different. In case, if the both person are like agree each other, they can just go in the court and they just do depending upon their own decisions. But right now, this right, this is not right, is being given to the poor persons. Yeah, so you cannot marry with different religions. This is the thing. What do you think about it?
Love jihad.
Yeah, love jihad. Yes. Yeah. So
actually, basically, I feel that this is a personal thing. Government should not take part in all kind of things. If Hindu loves Muslim or Muslim loves Hindu, doesn't matter. Both are loving each other. But intention is, if intention is good, then everything is good. Because we all are human beings. So I think.
Yeah, this thing you were saying, yeah, but it, let's say if you go for that, then it's not like you cannot marry because it is not means implemented in our rights. Means now the rule has been came. I think I don't have any kind of knowledge about politicians and all, but yes, still I know this thing. Because I used to read the newspapers and sometimes it came news, and I used to read and. Then I got to know that there is person who was like you know Muslim and that girl is like Hindu and they both you know married each other and then after that police came into their home and just picked up his collar and just
nowadays because we are Indian country, India is a Hindu country, so people thinking that if they are doing like this, so our population will decrease. Maybe I think they are thinking like that, but we all are Indians, whether they are a Hindu or whether they are Muslim. We are Indian, we are human beings. If you cut my hand, it will come red color blood, and if you cut Muslim hands, red color blood. Both
we are made up of all like same matter, like there is no any difference.
It's only a difference in the name, but we are human beings. But intention should be not wrong. If love jihad, I don't know about this. But if Muslim or Hindu, both intention is good, then it's good.
Say that, but let's see what happens. Yeah, you are right actually. But the government policies is quite different actually. You know, they had just implement those rules and. Means their intention is like quite different as we people think. So it, that's why they have just implemented it because you cannot marry with that person and something like that. So yeah, I think it was great conversation. I think, you know, we had talked half an hour.
Oh my God, half an hour. I think it's very great conversation with you. So thank you very much and all the best for your rest of your exams.
Thanks a lot. Definitely, I will do my level best. Like there are two papers are left, and it will be finished Monday itself, and then I will get 5 or 6 days rest, and after that, my next semester exam is going to be started, and we'll just enter in third year. So yes, that's the thing.
Definitely, congratulations for your third year.
Yeah, and please help me like this because I enjoy a lot, you know, because I'm talking to you and it gives me a lot of exposure to keep talking with this thing because now I think I'm more comfortable with talking to you. What I feel is, and yeah, we can do more sessions, you know, and I will prepare. You can just let me know the topics and I will prepare and we'll talk like this.
Okay. Thank you very much. Okay, bye.
Yeah, thanks. Bye.